स्वेच्छा केसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासितेन्दवः त्रायन्तां वो मधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नकाः. We just saw an introduction of about how what dhvani is, and it is that it is the most without dhvani, today's sahitya shastra, any discussion about sahitya shastra cannot happen without dhvani. It takes such a foremost place in the entire sahitya shastra world today. So he spoke about Anandavardhana and Abhinav Gupta have talked about this concept in the 9th century and 10th century, and there have not come a concept which can refute the existence of dhvani. That is the greatness of this concept, and that's why this is a very important text to study when you are pursuing sahitya. He starts off by saying the different vipratipatti or vikalpaha. Dhvani vishaye, there are a lot of vikalpa. That is, people are thinking about what dhvani is, whether, you know, dhvani does not exist. See, acceptance for any new concept is always late. It is not very easily done by people, correct? So the first karika enlists that, and he says, काव्यस्यात्मा ध्वनिरिति बुधैः यः समाम्नात पूर्वः तस्याभावं जगदुरपरे भक्तमाहुस्तमन्ये केचिद्वाचां स्थितमविषये तत्त्वमूचुस्तदीयं तेन ब्रूमः सहृदयमनः प्रीतये तत्स्वरूपम्. वै डू यू वांट टू टॉक अबाउट द ध्वनिस्वरूप? हि गिव्स् दि एक्सप्लेनेशन् हियर्. दिस् इस् काव्यस्य आत्मा ध्वनिः इति. ध्वनि इस् दि आत्मा आफ् अ काव्यम् इति. Budaihi yaha samamnata purvaha. It was proclaimed samamnata purvaha. Samyak asamantat mnataha prakatitaha. As I told you, Anandavardhana has written the vritti also for the shloka. We'll first finish the shloka and then go to that. So budhaha actually are kavya tattva vidh. One who understands the concepts that are there in the kavya. One who knows the all the different aspects that involve a kavya. So tadrisha panditaihi. So samamnata purvaha, actually Anandavardhana does not give as kavya tattva vidhihi. He says it in the vritti, but when you say samamnata purvaha, it means it has been proclaimed before. But the concept of dhvani, nobody has said dhvani before. They have only talked about vyangya and vyanjaka bhava. That is, there is something called a suggestor, there is something that is being suggested, and that whether that suggested is the Atma or not. And they have also said that the Vyangyam is what you have to look for. That is the most appreciative quality in a Kavyam. People have shown that before, but they have not given it such a prominence and dealt with it in such detail, and that is why I'm going to say, he says, so kavyasya atma dhvanihi iti budaihi samamnata purvaha. They have already said it before avichinnena pravahena paramparaya. That is, in a without any stop in their communication, there have been people at random constantly through the history of sahitya that they have said all this. Another version of budaihi is vyakaranai vayyakaranaihi. So prathamohi vibdamsaha vayyakaranaha, hence budaha indicates vayyakaranaha. Why we can't take that is the dhvani or the sphota that they say is completely different from the dhvani that is said by kavya shastravit. People who are experts in Sahitya Shastra, the dhvani that they say is only the vyangyartha, or as I said in the either, it is dhvanyate or dhvane dhvanati. All of these things contribute towards the dhvani. And that the atma of a kavya is that vyangyartha or that rasadhvani or vastudhvani or alankarathvani. That is the atma of a kavya. Now, such a dhvani has not been described by Vayyakarana. Their attitude or the way they have explained it is very similar to Vachyartham than Vyangyartham. That's why the difference. So in order to not get confused by the Spotavada with the Dhvanivada, Anandavardhana starts off with Budhaihi Tattva Vidbihi Kavyasya Atma Dhvanihi Iti Samgitaha. Kavya Tattva Vidbihi. Those who have already mentioned about the presence of a Vyangyavanjaka Bhavam, and they have said that the Vyangyartha is the Dhvani or the Kavya Atma, I'm talking about those people. So those people will have already said that Kavyasya Atma Iti Yaha Paramparaya Samamnata Purvaha Samyak Asamantat Mnataha Prakatitaha. Tasya Abhavam Jagaduhu Apare. Apare, some people, Tasya Abhavam Jagaduhu. They have spoken about the non-existence of it. They say that it doesn't exist. Dhvani does not exist. That is your Abhavavadi. Bhakta Mahuhu Tam Anye. Tam Dhvanimeva Tam Dhvanimeva Anye, other people, yet another set of people have said that it is Bhaktam. Bhajyate Anena Iti Bhaktam. So that Bhaktam means Lakshana. I can include Dhvani into Lakshana. That is what some other, yet another set of people have started. Kechit Vacham Abhishaye Sthitam Tattvam Iti Tadiyam Uchuhu. Iti Uchuhu. So some other people, yet another set of people have said that Kechit Vacham Abhishaye Sthitam Tattvam. It is a Tattvam. It is a principle that is beyond the words of expressive quality. It is beyond an expression. So avacham abhishaye sthitam, it does not come within the range of perception or range of words. Iti uchuhu, some people have said that also. So tadiyam tena brumaha, tadiyam tattvam. If you say tadiyam tattvam, then dvanehe tattvam kechit avacham abhishaye sthitam iti uchuhu. So dvanehe tattvam, some people have spoken that it is beyond the words. Kechit satena tasmat karanat tena bruma sahrdayamanah pritaye tatswarupam. So tena tatswarupam brumaha tasmat karanat dvanehe swarupam brumaha. I'm going to talk about the essential nature of dvani. What is its definition? What are the different classifications of dvani? And give it a proper structure here. So tena tasmat karanat tatswarupam dvanehe swarupam kimartham vakshye sahrdaya manah pritaye. Sahrdaya samana hrdayaha, one who is in the same wavelength, one who can understand what the poet, the one who can understand the intention of the poet, one who can understand or experience it the way the poet wants the other person to enjoy. That is a sahrdaya. Samana hrdayaha, one who is in the same wavelength. So sahrdaya manah pritaye, in order to please the connoisseurs, I am going to talk about the swarupam of dhvani. Now let's look at the vritti. Budaihi kavya tattva vidbihi kavyasya atma dhvanihi iti samkitaha paramparaya yaha samamnata purvaha is equal to samyak asamantat mnataha prakatitaha. Okay, tasya dvanehe sahridaya jana manav prakashamanasyapi abhavam anye jagaduhu. Sahridaya jana manav prakashamanasya, it is very evident in the mind of the connoisseurs. So sahridaya janana manasi sputataya prakashate dvanihi. Tathapi prakashamanasyapi dvanehe tasya abhavam anye jagaduhu. People say that it does not exist. Tad abhavavadinam cha ami vikalpaha sambhavanti. Now those abhavavadi are, there are three types of abhavavadi. Now in this shloka, he has given us three different misconceptions about dhvani. One is, some people are saying that dhvani does not exist. The second one is that he says dhvani is bhaktam ahuhu tamanye. They say that it is lakshana. Then the third one is kechit vacham avishaye sthitam. It is there, but it cannot be explained. That is your third paksha. So these are the three dhvani pratipadinaha. And the first one is abhavavadi. The abhava arises because it is a viparyaya. It is a different, completely altogether different understanding of the concept at all. He is completely opposed to it. If you look at how Anandavardhana has placed all these pratiwadis, it is actually in a gradation manner. Each one of them are coming closer and closer to the concept of dhvani and how to explain it. That's why he has arranged it then in that manner. First itself, he says, see, this abhavavadi, it is very difficult to, in Neeti Shatakam, he'll say, Natu pratinivishta murkha jana chittam aradayat. It is so easy to talk to people. It is easy to take oil from Sikatasu Tailamapi Yatnena Kuryat. Very easy to take out oil even from mud in sand. He will say a lot of these things, and then at the end he will say, Natu Pratinivishta Murkha Jana Chittam Aradhayet. It's very difficult to bring back the mind of a Murkha. Pratinivishta. He is not at all receptive to your words. He has completely turned his face away from your words. So it's difficult to control him, or it's tough to make him see your point. That's why he places the abhavavadins first, and he says, if you are not able to understand my point, I don't want to be bothered by you. So he first removes that section. So abhavavadinaha, you know, it's very easy to tell, you know, asti eva dvanihi. If you want to believe, you believe, otherwise go. The other two people, whether it is a lakshana person or alakshaniyata, that is, it's very difficult to understand, to explain what this dvani is. You only experience it with your mind. You only understand it. I cannot put it in words. Those people also, you can say, no, I can put it in words. There is a possibility of bringing them to your fold, lakshana or vyanjana, because they accept that there is something called dvani, but it is not something beyond what exists. It can be explained through the concept that I am saying. That is your lakshana. That is bhaktavadi, where there is a sandeha moolaka pakshaha, and there is a doubt as to whether the vyangyartha is completely different from the lakshyartha or not. Why can't it be included with the lakshyartha, just as how the lakshyartha or the intended meaning is understood. When I say gangayam ghoshaha, ganga pravahe ghoshaha na vidyate, kintu ganga tate samipe pravahasya samipe tate vidyate ghoshaha. Iti lakshanaya, we take that intended meaning, which means you are closer to where I am, but you have a doubt, you are not able to distinguish between the lakshyartha and the vyangyartha. So it's easier to attack you. I can tell you something. Next is alakshaniyata vadi, which is ajnana moolakam. I know dhvani, but I'm not able to express it. All I can say is it is beautiful. It's very attractive. It's close to my mind. These are not things that can work as far as theory goes. You can only just, you know, say, ah, oh, what a beautiful shloka, why it is beautiful, what makes it so beautiful, what are the different parts that you have to look for to understand its beauty. Those, that is necessary, that is jnanam. Hence, alakshaniyata vadinaha are ajnanamoolaka paksha. Now he goes on and writes the vritti for this shloka. He just continues with it by saying, ami vikalpaha, abhavasya ami vikalpaha vartante. That's what he said last, the end of that line. Yeah. Tad tasmat karanat abhavavadinam cha ami vikalpaha sambhavanti. There are three possibilities for an abhavavadi. So the three possibilities are, pratamav pakshaha, one person says, koyam dvanihi. See, I know about alankara, I know about guna, the riti, vritti. There are so many aspects that Bama has said, Dandin has said. There are alankarikas who have talked about different aspects of kavya. Now, what is this new thing that you are saying? Dhani. That is your first paksha. Second paksha is, dhani cannot exist. There are only these aspects. That is the second paksham. Tritiya pakshaha, abhavavadinam. Uktacharatva hetushu eva antarbhavaha. There are some 100 different types of parts of a kavya that I have said, which are charutva hetu, which contribute to the beauty of the kavya, if you say that dhvani is something different, or if you say that it is an aspect that is found in kavya, it is also a contributor of beauty, hence it has to be included within this section. So ukta charutva hetu shweva antarbhavaha tasya dhvanehe. Now let's go to the vritti. Tatra kechida achikshiran, the pratham of pakshaha. So tatra abhavavadishu madhye. So in among the abhavavadi, one section of the abhavavadi achakshiran, they have said shabdartha shariram davat kavyam. Now they are enlisting all these things. So we looked at the kavya purusha table, right? Remember, have that in mind. So shabda and artha form the outer body of a kavyam. Tatra cha kavye cha shabdagataha charutva hetavaha. Those beautifying aspects that are based on shabda, or the those which beautify the words, are anuprasadayaha prasiddaha eva shabdalankaraha. Anuprasa, yamaka, these are the varieties of shabdalankara that beautify the words that are present and have no connection with the meaning. That is prasiddaha eva, it is well known. Arthagatascha upamadayaha, and arthagataha, arthalankaraha, upama, utpreksha, rupakam, all of these are also known. From Bharata's Natya Shastra, there were only 4 alankaras. Bhamaha increased it to 32. Dandin increased it to 32, Bhamaha to 64, and so on and so forth. Today we have 300 alankaras that are present. So there are so many arthalankaras that keep coming up at every stage in the history of Sahitya literature. Why don't we just include it in that, right? So arthagataha cha upamadayaha prasiddaha eva. Next is varna sanghatana dharmaha cha ye madhuryadayaha te api pratiyante. Varna sanghatana dharmaha, sanghatana and the sherke, that is the way in which the letters are combined with each other to form a shloka, which gives out a madhuryam or ojas. These are all the different types of kavya gunaha. So madhuryadayaha kavya gunaha pratiyante are also known, which are based on the varna sanghatana dharmaha. You will read about guna, their definition, and the different types of guna and how it occurs in kavya, in Kavya Prakasham second part, in 8th and 9th ullasa. Tadanatirakta vrittayaha, vrittayaha api yaha kaischitu upanagarikadayaha, upanagarikadyaha prakashitaha tapigataha shravanagocharam. Na tad anatiriktaha guna anatirikta vrittayaha. So guna and alankara form a set called charutva hetavaha, something which is not beyond that. See, dvani, he attacks dvani by saying that dvani, you say, is beyond all these charutva hetu, right? Tad anatirikta vrittayaha, something called vritti also exists, which is not beyond the alankara, shabdagata or arthagata upamaha or varna sangatana dharmaha. This vritti also is present, which people have said, which is upanagarikadyaha. You have Kaishiki, Arabhati, Satvati, and all that. There is also upanagarikadi vrittayaha. There are many different types called vritti. Vritti is again a technical term. Anatirikta vrittayaha means anatirikta tvena ye vrittayaha vartante. Anatirikta tvena vartante iti anatirikta vrittayaha. So the first one is actually a verb. The second vrittayaha is a technical term, vritti, which indicates kaishiki, bharati, etc. Upanagarikadyaha prakashitaha, those which have been said, the upanagarika, etc. Other vrittis have also been said, which ta api gataha shravana gocharam, we have heard about that also. Ritayaha, riti is a style of the poet, which encompasses all of these guna, vritti, etc., etc., which is why there be Gaudi, Panchali, the way a poet writes. Whether it's a sweet style of writing is why there be. Gaudi is a very harsh form of writing. That is योर् स्टैल् आफ् रैटिङ्ग् विच् इस् रीति. रीतयः च वैदर्भिः प्रभृतयः, तद्व्यतिरिक्तः कोऽयं ध्वनिः नाम इति. सो बियाण्ड् दीस् वाट् इस् दिस् ध्वनि देट् यु आर् टाकिङ्ग् अबौट्. ओके, now I'm not going deep into what each one is, what guna is, what vritti is, and what riti is, because we will be reading it in Kavya Prakasham. I don't want to go very deeply into this. And at that point of time, he is going to show that dhvani is different from riti, dhvani is different from vaidarbhi, dhvani is actually different from guna, sanghatana. There is a big discussion also later. So at that point of time, I will give more detailed definition about what that is. Now, this is your pratama paksha. The second paksha is anye bruyuhu nastyeva dvanihi. Prasiddha prasthana vyatirekinaha kavya prakarasya kavyatva hanehe sahridaya hridaya ahladi shabdartha mayatvameva kavya lakshana. Nastyeva dvanihi. Dvani cannot exist at all, because the reason being, प्रसिद्ध प्रस्थान व्यतिरेकिणः काव्य प्रकारस्य काव्यत्व हानेः, दट इज काव्यत्व हानेः इज फिफ्थ केस, पुट अ कॉमा आफ्टर दैट. सो प्रसिद्ध प्रस्थान व्यतिरेकिणः काव्य प्रकारस्य, काव्य प्रकारस्य, इफ यू आर टॉकिंग ऑफ एनी एस्पेक्ट ऑफ अ काव्यम which is prasiddha prasthana vyatireki, vyatireki which is different from the popular prasthana marga, from the popular things that are present in a kavyam. If you are talking of something that is different from what is already being mentioned, then it only contributes towards the hani, kavyatva hanihi eva. It loses, kavya loses its kavyatvam, the quality of being a kavya, because it is different from that which is already present and that which has already been discussed by other alankarikas. So prasiddha prasthana vyatirekinah kavya prakarasya kavyatva hanehe, because it provides a hani, it reduces the effect of a kavya, it is like a dosham. Sahridaya hridaya ahladi shabdarthamayatvam eva kavya lakshana. So the definition of a kavya is only shabda and artha, shabdarthamayatvam, and though that shabda and artha should be akhladi, it should attract the mind, and that to whose heart it should attract, sahridaya hridaya akhladi, it should be attractive to the hearts of the connoisseur. Such words and artha only form the kavyam. Nacha ukta prasthana atirekinah margasya tat sambhavati. Ukta prasthana, if I have talked about a certain prasthana margam, ukta margat atirekinah margasya, a path which is not trodden before, that cannot happen. That is, it cannot provide that akhladakaratvam for sahridaya hridaya. उक्तप्रस्थानात् उक्तप्रस्थानेभ्यः व्यतिरेकी मार्गः चेत् तस्य सहृदय हृदयस्य आह्लादित्वं न भवति. तत् न च तत् समन् तत् समत अन्तःपातिनः सहृदयान् कांश्चित् परिकल्प्य. ओके, न च तत् सो यु आल्वेस् टेक् द न एण्ड् कनेक्टेड् वित् द वर्ब. So even in the earlier sentence, ukta prasthana atirekinaha margasya tat na sambhavati. In the same way here, tat samata antapatinaha, tat samata, those who accept it, you know, you call upon some of your own people who just get together and then talk so highly about dhvani. Tat samata antapatinaha sahridayana kanschit parikalpya. You are creating a set of followers for yourself. Kamschita tat samata antapatinaha, those who are all accept this tat dvani samata antapatinaha, those who fall within the group of people who accept dvani. Dvani angikara antapatinaha sahridayan kamschita parikalpya sanchitya, that is, you gather people and then tat prasidhya ध्वनौ तत्प्रसिद्ध्या बिकॉज दैट गैदरिंग हैज गेन्ड अ पॉप्युलैरिटी ध्वनौ काव्य व्यपदेशः प्रवर्तितः अपि इवन इफ ध्वनि गेट्स द नेम ऑफ काव्य व्यपदेश काव्य प्रवर्तितः अपि इवन दो इट इज पीपल हु गेट टुगेदर लाइक दिस एंड हैव स्टार्टेड नेमिंग ध्वनि एज अ काव्य सकल विद्वन मनोग्राहिताम न अवलंबते कैच दैट ना एंड पुट इट हियर so sakala vidvan manograhitam it will not get the acceptance of all vidwans na avalambate it will not attain the acceptance manograhitam of all vidwan okay so first one was koyam dvanihi next one is nasti eva dvanihi even if you try to create your own following and gathering and say that dvani is kavya dvani is kavya it will not be accepted by the general intelligentsia so sagala vidvan manograhitam na avalambate punarapare tasya abhavam anyatha kateyuhu there may be people who talk about the dvani abhava tasya abhavam dvanehe abhavam anyatha kateyuhu anya prakarena evam kateyuhu they may say like this na sambhavatyev dvani nama apurvah kaschit See, it is not something unique. Dvanihi nama apurvaha kaschit na sambhavatyeva. Even if it is present, it is only ukta charutva hetushu antarbhavaha. Dvanihi nama apurvaha. Apurvaha, something which is not known before. Kaschit na sambhavatyeva, it cannot happen. Kamaniyakam anativartamanasya tasya. When you say dvani, it is the beauty of a poem that you are talking about kamaniyakam beauty anati vartamanasya it is not an outlier as far as a beauty is when we say it is a dvani shloka we only say it is so beautiful the dvani is beautiful you appreciate the dvani it is kamaniyakam it adds beauty to the poetry adds beauty to the kavya so kamaniyakam anati vartamanasya since it does not exist beyond the saundarya vastu तस्य ध्वनेः उक्तेष्वेव चारुत्वहेतुषु अन्तर्भावात् यू कैन इंक्लूड इट इन द एन नंबर ऑफ थिंग्स दैट आई हैव सेड अबाउट हे चारुत्वहेतु तेषां अन्यतमस्यैव वा अपूर्व समाख्या मात्र करणे यत्किंचन कथनं स्यात् सो तेषां दैट इज तेषां अन्यतमस्यैव इट इज वन ऑफ दोस and apurva samakhya matra karane yat kinchana kathanam you can't just you know since it is one of included within one of the charutva hetu shu antarbhava karanateva tesham anyatamasyaiva so tesham ityukte charutva hetu nam anyatamasya dvanehe apurva samakhya matra karane apurvaha ayam dvanihi iti namakarane naiva yat kinchana kathanam syate if you want you say whatever you want you can't it is I cannot accept it as something unique it is if I say 1 2 3 4 5 then you can say it is the sixth one that's all its status is this is the abhavavadi paksha the conclusion for the abhavavadi the next section is the conclusion so kincha vagvikalpanam anantyat sambhavatyapi vakasminschit kavya lakshana vidayibhi prasiddhaihi apradarshite prakaraleshe dhvani dhvani riti यदेतत् अलीकसहृदयत्व भावना मुकुलित लोचनैः नृत्यते तत्र हेतुं न विद्मः सो द अभाववादि सेस् किञ्च वाग्विकल्पानाम् आनन्त्यात् देर् इस् वाग्विकल्पानाम् आनन्त्यात् द विकल्प देट् इस् द डिफ्रेण्ट् टैप्स् आफ् vak that comes out of a kavi is it can be more creative right so there can be different types of things that come out of a kavi's mouth and so the anantyam or the plentiful creativity that is present in the, see, art is something which is constantly changing. The same way Kavyam also, you find many different things. As the intelligentsia increases, you know, what we see today, there are many people who keep saying, you know, it's not like the olden days. Olden days, there were people who could achieve much more. We are not able to. No, it's just the things that are being achieved and created are actually increasing over the years. So you, I don't know, somebody tomorrow might come up with something which has not been seen by so many people in these past few centuries. And that small thing, you cannot take it and say that dhwani, aha, it is the best thing, and close your eyes and dance with it. I don't understand why they are doing this, he says. This is the conclusion of the Tabavadi. So, kincha, further, vag vikalpanam shabda vaichitriyat, shabda vaichitriyanam anantyat, because there are a lot of different varieties of shabda words, because of that, sambhavatyapi va kasminschit kavya lakshana vidayibihi, somewhere kasminschit, in some place or in some work, kavya lakshana vidayibihi prasiddhaihi pradarshite, kasminschit, in some kavya lakshana vidayibihi, those who know the, or those who enumerate the different lakshanas of a kavya, those who different aspects of a kavya, those people prasiddhaihi, those famous people can come up with some small aspect which is apradarshitam, which has not been shown before, prakara leshe, which is a little small prakare, that is an aspect, and say that it is dhvanihi, dhvanihi iti, they say that it is dhvani. And what do they do? Yad etat alika sahridayatva bhavana, a false rasikatva. They join some people, they just group together and they say, we are the best sahridaya. You don't understand. Even for music, a lot of people will say, you know, this person is the best and that person is not. So a small gathering of people will just join together and say, you know, this person's song is the best. The rest are all, he's saying like that. It's like favoritism, fan following. No, you have, you create a false fan following for yourself. Sahridayatva bhavana, mukulita lochanaihi, you close your eyes and rityate, you're dancing. Tatra hetum navitma. I don't know what the reason for this thing is. Sahasrashahi mahatmabihi, thousands of people before have given alankara prakaraha prakashitaha prakashyante cha. I told you the this thing, right? When you look at the different alankaras that they have, people have said, right, from 4 to 300 today, people are coming up with newer and newer alankara prakara. So sahasrashaha mahatmabihi, great people, thousands of great people have come up with alankara prakaraha prakashitaha, they have said and they will say prakashyante cha, they are being shown by people. Na tesham eshadasha shruyate, I have not seen anybody jumping up and down with this, that I have found a new alankara and it is the best alankara, it is the kavya atma. Nobody is saying that. Tesham mahatmanam eshadasha na shruyate mukalita lochanaihi nrityamana dasha na shruyate. Tasmat pravada matram dhvanihi. It is just a rumor that four people have joined together and they are trying to make it into a great concept. Natu asya kshodakshamam tattvam kinchidapi prakashayitum shakyam. It is very difficult to highlight even a little aspect, tattvam, a principle, which is kshodakshamam, which can kshodaha is analysis, which is capable of poruthukka koodiya oru analysis poruthukkra oru idu kadaiyadhu adukku, which can tolerate any analysis. So you write a paper, you have a theory, you propose something, and then you go and read it in front of it's like a peer review. He's saying peer review is not possible for such a dhwani. So you go and show it in front of people and they will analyze it and they will give you points or something like that, right? So here he says, your tattvam किञ्चिदपि प्रकाशयितुं न शक्यं यत् क्षोलक्षमम् अस्ति, दट् विच् केन् बि अनलैस्ड् आर् दट् विच् हेस् द केपबिलिटि आफ् टालरेटिङ्ग् सच् अनालिसिस्. तथा च अन्येन कृतः एव अत्र श्लोकः. देर् इस् समथिङ्ग् दट् समवन् हेस् डन् द श्लोक. यस्मिन् अस्ति न वस्तु किञ्चन मनः प्रह्लादिसालङ्कृति, व्युत्पन्नैः रचितं च नैव वचनैः वक्रोक्तिशून्यं च यत् काव्यं तत् ध्वनिना समन्वितम् इति प्रीत्या प्रशंसन् जडः नो विद्मो अभिददाति किं सुमतिना पृष्टस्वरूपं ध्वनेः. यस्मिन् सो इस् टाकिङ्ग् आफ् अ श्लोकं वेर् देर् इस् नो अलङ्कार, इट् इस् नाट् written with any clever turn of phrases, there is no vakrokti, but that shloka has dhvani, tadvanina samanvitam iti jadaha prashamsan, pritya jadaha prashamsan. Jada, a dull headed person, praises a shloka which has nothing, which doesn't have any attractive alankara, or it is not vyutpannaihi vachanaihi, like naishadakara or magha. There should be words that are proclaiming his intelligence. Such words are also not used. Yasmin asti na vastu kinchana manav prakladi salankrati. Yasmin padye athava kavye manav prakladi मनोहररूपं सालङ्कृति अलङ्कारयुक्तं वस्तु किञ्चन न अस्ति. देर् इस् नो सब्जेक्ट् मेटर् दट् इस् देर् विच् हेज़् एन् अलङ्कार आर् विच् इस् अट्राक्टिव् टु द मैण्ड्. सो व्युत्पन्नैः वचनैः नैव रचितम्, इट् इस् आल्सो नाट् रिटन् वित् व्युत्पन्न vyutpannaihi vachanaihi, that is a lot of shabdalankara. So the first one talks of arthalankara, the second talks of shabdalankara. So the word and beauty and the classic, you use different nala, how do I say that, the repetition of letters and all that, that is anuprasa upama, sorry, anuprasa yamaka, etc. So that type of shabdalankaras are also not used. Vyutpannaihi vachanaihi naiva rachitam vakrokti shunyam chayat. Vakrokti is clever turn of phrase, I told you. So that vakrokti is also absent. Then what happens? Kavyam tat dhvanina samanvitam iti jadaha pritya prashamsan. He just likes the author. Pritya. So just out of an affection, a dumb person, a dull-headed person says that this kavyam has dhvani. समन्वितम् इति प्रशंसन् जडः सुमतिना पृष्टः स्वरूपं, ध्वनेः स्वरूपं पृष्टः चेत् नो विद्मः इति अभिददाति. द अन्वयं गोस् लैक् दट्. सुमतिना सं विद्वान् पण्डितः सः पृच्छति ध्वनेः स्वरूपं कथय इति, जडं पृच्छति. सो ही कम्स् एन् आस्क्स् यू नो वाट् इस् द स्वरूपम् आफ् ध्वनि. And he says immediately, oh, I don't know. No vidmaha. Na janami. Iti abhidadati. He says, I don't know about it. Huh? So that is the conclusion of this abhavavadi. Right? Next one is bhaktam. Ahustamanni. Oh, no. Ah, yes. In my text, no? The lochanam, and there is a Hindi and everything, so I have to turn some 5 pages to come to the next line. so the last one. Yasmin asti navastu kinchana manav prakladi salankriti vyutpannai rachitam nacha naiva vachanaihi vakrokti shunyam cha yat kavyam tad dvanina samanvitam iti pritya prashamsan jadaha nav vidmo abhidadati iti vakti na vidmaha na jani maha iti vakti kim sumatina prushtaswarupam dhanehe. He is going to attack each and every one of this abhavavadi behind and say later in the text and say that dhvanihi asti eva iti vadati. Bhaktamahustamanye. Right? Anye, another set of people, tam dhvani samgitam kavyatmanam gunavrittihi iti ahuhu. Ahuhu, abdina aswarasa suchitaha. He is not That is Anandavardhana does not conform to this view. Bhaktam ahuhu. Some others, yet others, say that this is bhaktam. Bhajyate, sevyate, padarthena, prasiddhataya, utprekshyate, iti, bhaktihi, dharmaha, abideyena, samipyadihi, tataha, agataha, bhaktaha, lakshanikaha, artaha. I'm reading from Lochanam, which is the correct definition of bhakti. Bhakti means don't look at devotion. It is not that bhakti. The vyutpatti of this is bhajyate, sevyate, padarthena, prasiddhataya, abideyena, samipyadehe, tataha agataha, bhaktaha. So first you have a word which is the vachaka shabdaha, which gives you the padartha, which gives you the meaning of that word. So that padartha prasiddhataya, because of samipya or any other, like in Gangayam Goshaha, or prasiddham, something famous which you can attach another meaning to it, which is an intended meaning. So when I say the whole world is laughing at you, it is not that the entire, the globe is laughing, it has a mouth. It's not like a cartoon there. Right, so the whole world is laughing. It is a prasiddha way of saying it. So prasiddhataya, because it is a famous way of saying that. If I say the world is laughing, it means the people inside are laughing. Not every people. If I am here, would I say that someone in Japan is laughing at me? Those people who even hear about this would laugh at you, or those people who reside beside me are laughing at me. So the lakshana has its own limitations. That's all. So bhajyate padarthena prasiddhataya utprekshyate. You understand something. You fancy in your mind something else. Right? Bhaktihi dharmaha abideyena samipyadehe. So abideyaha is that which is the vachaka shabda, the primary meaning, and the primary word. So the abideyaha is the primary meaning. It is very close to the primary meaning. And hence we take the intended meaning, which is the lakshanikaha artaha. Bhaktaha, bhaktam ahuhu, tam dhvanim anye bhaktam ahuhu, lakshanika artham ahuhu. So some people say that it is the lakshyartha. Okay, so anye tam dhvani samgitam kavyatmanam gunavrittihi iti ahuhu. Another word for that is also guna, or gaunaha artaha, apradanaha artaha. Gauna means, which is that is also intended. Okay, so there is a, instead of directly saying that Ganga tate goshaha vartate, my point of saying Gangayam goshaha vartate means I am talking of yadrisha pavanatvam Gangayam vartate tadrisha pavanatvam goshe api vartate. Iti suchanartham, I use this. So this is the pradhanatvam. Gaunam is your intended meaning, which is a secondary. So that is gunavritti, is the lakshana, is also known as, this is the secondary. Instead of saying apradhana, you can take it as a secondary process that you use, which is called gunavrittihi. Once you study the first Kavya Prakasha, second Ullasam, in the second Ullasa, there is a detailed discussion on the Lakshana, Abhida Lakshana and Vyanjana. That will clear off a lot of these things. So Guna Vrittihi is equal to Lakshana. So Dvani, Dvani Samgitam Kavyatmanam Guna Vrittihi iti Ahuhu. Yadya Picha Dvani Shabda Sankirtanena काव्यलक्षण विदायिभिः गुणवृत्तिः अन्यः वा कश्चित् प्रकारः प्रकाशितः तथापि अमुख्यवृत्त्या काव्येषु व्यवहारं दर्शयत ध्वनिमार्गः मनाक् सृष्टः अपि न लक्षितः इति परिकल्प्य एवमुक्तं भक्तमाहुस्तमन्ये. सो यद्यपि ईवन्दो ध्वनिशब्दसङ्कीर्तनेन, ईवन् दो पीपल् हेव् टाक्ड् अबौट् द वर्ड् ध्वनि एण्ड् Kavyalakshana Vidayibihi Gunavrittihi Anyaha Va Kaschit Prakaraha Prakashitaha. So he is attacking those people and he says Budaihi Samamnata Purvaha. There may have been people who have sort of touched the process of dvani, but they have not completely understood it, or they were not capable of explaining it completely. So yadyapi, even though dvani shabda sankirtanena, they have used the word dvani. Kavya lakshana vidayibihi, these alankara shastra people, gunavrittihi anyahava. That is why I said sandeha moolakam. Either it is the true lakshana, either they have mentioned lakshana, or they have mentioned something else, which means it is tatparyartham. Or anyahava, kaschit prakaraha, either they use tatparya or they use gunavritti. Tatparya means, when I say gatoastam arkaha, it is naturally understood that I have to go and light a lamp, right? So that is the tatparyam, that is what the speaker wishes to convey to me. Dvani does not work like that. The speaker may just appreciate the scenery and say gatoastam arkaha, but the one, each one takes a different meaning in their mind. That is dvani. Tatparyam means vaktri icha is getting translated to the karta or shrota. Okay, that is your kaschit anyav prakaraha. So gunavrittihi anyahava na kaschit prakaraha prakashitaha. यद्यपि न प्रकाशितः तथापि अमुख्यवृत्त्या काव्येषु व्यवहारं दर्शयता ध्वनिमार्गः मनाक् स्पृष्टः. नौ दिस् सेण्टेन्स् इस् नाट् अबौट् द लक्षण पीपल्. सो ही सेयिङ्ग् there may have been other people who have spoken of bhakti not only to represent lakshana, that is gunavritti or tatparya. They may have spoken about some other gaunavritti, which is amukhya vritti, which is another process secondary to this main primary meaning. They may have mentioned it, but they have only touched the dvani marga manak sprishtaha na lakshitaha. They have not been able to explain the dvani marga. So yadyapi, even though those people who have talked about dvani shabda sankirtanena by speaking of the word dvani, gunavrittihi anyavaha na prakashitaha, they may not mean that it is lakshana or tatparyam. Okay, they could actually be talking of some other tathapi amukhya vrittya. They only talk about it as something which is secondary and not important. I want to show that it is extremely important in understanding of a kafya. Darshayata dvani margaha manak srushtaha api na lakshitaha iti parikalpya. By having that in mind, the Ananda Vardhana says bhaktamahustamanye. केचित् पुनः लक्षणकरणशालीनबुद्धयः, दोस् आलङ्कारिकास् ध्वनेः तत्त्वं, दोस् हू से दट् द प्रिन्सिपल् आफ् ध्वनि गिराम् अगोचरम् इति वदन्ति, सहृदय हृदय संवेद्यमेव, दट् विच् इस् ओन्ली अण्डर्स्टुड् बै द सहृदय, द हार्ट् आफ् अ सहृदय, संवेद्यमेव समाख्यातवन्तः तेन एवं विदासु. सो सम् आफ् देम् हेव् आल्सो स्पोकन् लैक् दिस्. तेन तस्मात् कारणात् इत्युक्ते ध्वनेः एवं विप्रतिपत्तीनां सद्भावात् एवं विदासु विमतिषु स्थितासु, दीस् मिस्कन्सेप्शन्स् अबौट् ध्वनि आर् एक्सिस्टिङ्ग्, हेन्स् सहृदय मनः प्रीतये तत् स्वरूपं भ्रूमः. ऐ एम् गोयिङ्ग् टु टाक् अबौट् द स्वरूप आफ् ध्वनि. सो दिस् इस् स्टिल् वि आर् इन् दि एक्स्प्लेनेशन् आफ् द फस्ट् कारिका, काव्यस्यात्मा ध्वनिरिति बुधैः. So the last line of that is tena bruma sahrdaya manah pritaye tat swarupam tasya hi dvanehe swarupam sakala satkavi kavya upanishad. We'll look at that later, because this sentence is an avatarika for the dvani swarupam. Explain the, he starts off with the dvani swarupam and the next karika. And this is like an avatarika for that, so we will deal with it next class. Sariya? Okay.